Right, next up on the list, we've got some cultural theory. Now, remember, there's lots of different branches. I'll just reset my timer so now we're starting. There are lots of different branches of subcultural theory. We are going to focus mainly on one for the first part, probably, of your essay. And that's looking at functionalist subcultural theory. Now, because we know it's functionalist, we know we've still got the same section over here as we did with our normal functionalism. Structural, macro, official statistics are going to be good. So why do we need functionalist subcultural theory? And the reason that we have functionalist subcultural theory developing is based on the weaknesses of Merton. Now, Merton is a straight functionalist, the writer of strain theory. And what we remember from Merton is he doesn't look at group crime. He's not talked about. He doesn't talk about it. And then the other one is he doesn't talk about crime that is non-utilitarian, which means crime that's not for money. And we know that there's lots of crime that exists that is not for money. So we've got two big problems of Merton, the straight functionalist, which we then need to look at when it comes to subcultural theory. So we're going to begin with him, but he's not a functionalist subcultural theorist. So you basically need to explain the fact that we see this developing from him. Now, we can start off with Cohen. When in doubt, drop a C-bomb in your exam. This is Albert Cohen, not Stanley Cohen. And Albert Cohen is obviously talking about status frustration. Now, when it comes to status frustration, we've got to recognize that it is working class boys in education. This is where status frustration primarily occurs for Cohen. What's going to happen is working class boys start to do worse compared to the middle class boys. And when they do worse, they see their status drop. They need to increase that status. So how do they do it? Well, they can't do it in school, so they have to do it out of school through delinquent and deviant behaviour. Vandalism, smashing the place up, you know, throwing stones, breaking windows, all of that stuff that you know that we might see younger people doing, fighting, things like that. They're going to do it because they need to increase their status. So the criminality and the deviance and the delinquents becomes a way to improve their status, which they'd lost when they were in school. How is this functionalist? Because we know a lot of the ideas about functionalism are ideas about how homogenous society is and how the norms and values we share are in consensus. Well, that's true, but Cohen's saying that at the start there is some consensus. You know, all the kids want to do well at school. Just so happens that the working class lads are culturally deprived. They don't know how to act at school, and they're not built with the tools needed to kind of gain them success within that field. Then we move on to Cloward and Olin, blocked opportunities. Who's it blocked opportunities for? Well, the blocked opportunities are for the working classes. Therefore, usually the working class boys. Now, remember, when it comes to Cloward and Olin's theory, it's subcultural theory. So the blocked opportunities give them the option to fall into three types of subculture: a criminal one, a conflict one, or a retreatist one. Your criminal subculture is your typical subculture, which is trying to get money, you know, your gang. Your conflict subculture is like your hooligans. If they can't get into a gang, they'll fight. There might be football hooligans on a match day. And then, of course, using Merton's term retreatism, you know, the final subculture is just like a druggy kind of down and out, you know, not bothered about anything else other than drugs. Now, for Cloward and Olin, the most important thing that's going to affect your membership of these is going to be your geography, quite literally where you live, because criminal subcultures, gangs, only occur in stable working class areas, according to Cloward and Olin. You know, if you live in rural Shropshire, your chances of becoming the local Pablo Escobar and having a drug cartel, if you've got 20 houses and you're living in a hamlet, are very, very low. So geography is going to play a big impact in these. And if you can't get in that one, then you're getting that one. If you can't get in that one, you're getting that one.
So that's Cloud and Olin steering. Remember, we looked at how when the opportunities are blocked on a legitimate career ladder, they move to kind of this illegitimate career ladder and career structure over here, whereby you're rewarded in the same way for the same kind of skills. You know, for you to be the top of a drug cartel, you need to be smart, you need to be hardworking, you need to be good at your trade in the same way you would if you were a doctor. Just so happens that for Cloud and Olin, these working class boys are not going to have that chance to be a doctor, so consequently they end up, you know, a kingpin in a drug gang. Remember, their opportunities are blocked to be legitimate. They want legitimacy at the start, hence why Nightingale says in the Bloods and Crips what they really want is a job. So there's still that value consensus at the beginning that runs through the functionalist subcultural theories. Now, Miller is the final one. Miller is probably the least functionalist of all of these, and he's going to talk about the focal concerns of groups of working class lads that makes it inevitable, link back to Durkheim here, so we can see that he's a functionalist, that on the night out they're going to cause, you know, destruction and distress and smash the whole place up. Now, the focal concerns, there are six of them. Trouble, toughness, smartness, fate, autonomy, trouble, shouldn't have done this on this video, should I? Trouble, toughness, fate, autonomy, smartness, one other. I can't remember off the top of my head. You don't need to remember all of them off the top of your head either. But, you know, pick a couple that you think are the more profound ones. Excitement is the other one, there you go. That you are going to talk about and have a couple to go into some depth about. Okay, just say that the six, pick two to explore. Now, Miller's idea is that the working class lads, again, have got these different focal concerns. You know, they like going out drinking, trying to, you know, take drugs, sleep with as many women as they can do, get in some trouble with the bouncers, have a little scrap. That's what they want to do. And that's why it's inevitable that they'll commit crime. Obviously, a big weakness of this is that, well, is this just a working class? Is this just a stereotype? Or do you see a lot of this in middle class rugby teams on their night out? So what we've got are three of our functionists, probably in ascending order, all functionist subcultural writers, because now you can see explanations for non-utilitarian crime. You know, this conflict group, these working class focal concerns, none of these are about getting money. We've obviously then got our Marxist subcultural theories, which you could compare this against. So rather than the issue being, you know, status or issues of their opportunities potentially being blocked, which leads to criminality, or their norms and values being different and altered, our Marxist subcultural writers from the CCCS that you looked at last year, your Brake, your Hall and Jefferson, your Clark, your Corrigan, are going to say that it's a conscious resistance to capitalism. That the reason that they're going to join these subcultures is not necessarily for status. It's because they are making a decision to go and fight against the injustices of the system which they are in. And that is why they're going to take part in deviant, delinquent behaviour. Now, our big critic, and this is in probably a general evaluation, it could be his own paragraph, is Matzer. Now, Matzer is going to be very, very critical of any subcultural theory because of his ideas of drift. I'm going to draw out these two ladders, the illegitimate, you know, the legit and the illegit structures. Now, what he's going to say is that subcultural theory doesn't take into account that it's possible to drift back and forth between criminality and not being a criminal. He's going to say that when you're in these groups, you know, one of the weaknesses of Cloud and Olin is you can only be in one group, and it's kind of, well, can you not be in all, are not criminal groups kind of all a mesh of these? But you can't, once you're in them, you're in them, you're stuck in them. And he's going to say, well, actually, it doesn't happen all the time. Sometimes you could be in a gang, but then you work in a Tesco at the same time, and then you're back to your criminal activity. You can drift in and out. And young people, who we're mostly talking about when we look at subcultural theory, young working class people, are going to be more likely to be able to do that because they can practice techniques of neutralization. They can tell themselves and justify their behavior, which we don't see an explanation for here. Also, they're more likely to be showing these negative behaviors because as a young person who we're focusing on, these groups are more likely to exhibit their subterranean values. Remember, the underground values of our jealousy, lust, desire, that we want to keep pushed down, but in young people tend to explode a little bit more out of the top of the volcano by virtue of the fact that young people want to get a bit more control in their own lives. So so Matt's a very heavy critic of all subcultural theory. He's certainly a nice paragraph when you're talking about your evaluation. But as we've seen, you know, your subcultural theory mainly will focus at the start on your functionists. You've got your writers here. Some comparison to another different type of subcultural theory in Marxism, and you've got some evaluation there from Matzer. That's not just the only thing that goes into your essay, but I think that will, you know, be the foundations, the bones of a very useful one.